161st Street here in the Bronx. MLB The Show's got baseball from Yankee Stadium. Tonight, it's an AL Eastern Division matchup between the Toronto Blue Jays and the New York Yankees. Major League Baseball on The Show is next. Ready now is Marcus Semien, and we are set for baseball here this evening. This one is launched. Look at this. Gone. Into the box, Bo Bichette. And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1.
If you're on the mound right here, you got to trust your catcher and execute. You know who's coming up to the plate.
Hit on the ground out to short, fielded cleanly on to first, so a good bounce back pitch there as he gets the ground ball for the first out.
The first base
digging in next, Vladimir Guerrero Jr. One run in and one gone so far in this inning. Hit sharply on the ground. Throw in time at first for out number two. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Teoscar Hernandez. Bases are empty here with two men out. All even now, 2-2. Had to wait back on the changeup, and he did a good job just to make contact. The 2-2 one more time. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. So now into the box is Jonathan Davis. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Hit hard on the ground to short. Bichette picks it up cleanly. And a bit of a high throw that time, but no problem over there at first as they record the out.
The second baseman.
No one on with one DJ. Down. And that'll bring up DJ LeMahieu. Now the 2-1. Line drive base hit.
That is third. The right fielder.
Stepping in now, Aaron Judge. Grounded back up the middle to second for one. On to first, but not in time as he's in there ahead of the throw. Digging in will be Giancarlo Stanton. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and two away.
Stanton.
Now the 1-1 pitch is strike two swinging.
Take a step back right here. After three fastballs in a row, there is no chance he throws you a fourth.
A swing and a miss as he chased with two strikes, and that will retire the side. Second inning set to go, and standing in is the DH, Corey Dickerson. Here's the 1-2 delivery. Lays off, 2-2 now. Started to go. They'll look for the appeal down to third and ring him up, says the third base umpire. He's gone. So next to hit is Randall Grichuk. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and it's 1-2. And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there, two away.
Batting seven.
Into the box, Lourdes Gurriel. He'll attempt to put the ball in play for a change here with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. A ball and two strikes now. He jumps on this one. It's high and deep to center. Gone into the home bullpen for a home run.
Well, he's definitely off to a shaky start tonight, giving up two home runs in two innings. The good news is they were both solo shots. The bad news is the rest of the lineup is salivating in the dugout, waiting for their chance to face him.
So now to the plate, Santiago Espinal. Swing and a little blooper to center. LeMahieu is there, and the side is retired. And now in the box, Luke Voit, as they'll have 5, 6, and 7 here to start the home half of the second.
Hey, Matty, they need to get some offense going in this one. Getting a run back in this inning, give them a little bit of confidence that they can keep up in this game.
2-1 the count. Hard liner to center field. And that finds the outfield grass for a base hit. And this will kick off the base of the wall. And he's going to get to second now with nobody out.
Batting fifth, the third baseman, Joey.
In now, Gallo. Joey Gallo. A little early, and now it's even at 2-2. From the belt, kicks and deals. Smoked on the ground up the middle. And that'll get through into center field for a base hit. And they're on the board as now it's a 2-1 ball game.
Batting seven. The catcher.
At the plate, Gary Sanchez.
Sanchez.
Fastball well outside. And a fastball misses there. Ball four. Striding in is Anthony Rizzo. Base knock to the outfield could score the tying run from second. Now a swinging bunt. Gallo over at second. Sanchez on at first with nobody out. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Gurriel is there, and he'll bring this one in. Next, here is Andrew Velasquez trying here to plate the tying run from second.
Number 71.
The 3-1. Guide into very shallow right. Waiting on it is Hernandez. And that's the second out of the inning. And now, Jonathan Davis. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Two balls and a strike now to the Yankees leadoff man.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
Down the third baseline, but this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. 3-2 to the Yankees center fielder.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
And he misses with it for ball four, so the bases will be loaded now with two away.
DJ. LeMahieu.
Here's the 1-2. Got him. So the damage winds up not being as bad as it could have been as they'll strand the bases loaded. The side is retired. Now at the plate, Reese McGuire. And he'll start out their half of the third. Top of the order to follow. The 2-1. Now he spins on one here and drives it to deep right field. Gone to lead off the inning.
Man, this has been a rough one for this guy so far. That's the third homer he's allowed today. He better start keeping the ball down in the strike zone, or that total might continue to rise.
At the plate now, Marcus Semien. In the air down the right field line. But this will wind up being a foul ball. Now a swing and a miss as he picks up another one. Make it 4 strikeouts already, and there's your first out. Stepping up is Bo Bichette. 0-for-1 here in the early going. And there's ball 2 now. A check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike 2. Line drive, base hit.
next to the Blue Jays, the first baseman, Vladimir Guerrero.
Into the box, Vladimir Guerrero Jr. fouled away. Hit to short. LeMahieu for one. On to Rizzo, and it's a double play. Side retired. Bottom of the inning now, and next to bat will be the outfielder, Aaron Judge. The 1-2 is swung on and missed, strike three. Next to stand in is Giancarlo Stanton, struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Got him to miss the breaking ball there. Giancarlo Stanton becomes the second out in the bottom of the third. A leaping try, but it's out of his reach and into the outfield.
The third baseman, number 13. Joey.
To the plate now, Joey Gallo. And he lays off for a ball, 2-1.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
And a good at-bat that time as he lays off for ball four. And as a result, that'll move a runner up into
now
scoring batting. Position
catcher.
Now with two away.
Gary Sanchez.
The 3-1 pitch. And he misses again. Ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on balls.
The first baseman.
And that'll bring Anthony Rizzo to the plate. One of the bigger spots in the ballgame so far. Bases juiced now with two away. Simeon's there. Throw to second for the force out, and the side is retired. Teoscar Hernandez digging in now as we begin the top of the fourth. And a bouncing ball, foul. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch.
Ball down, 3-2.
Got him. Next will be the designated hitter, Corey Dickerson, looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at bat.
Dickerson
goes the other way as this is lined to left, but pretty much right at the left fielder as he takes it in for the second out. Two are gone now in the Blue Jays' half of the fourth, and the big right-handed bat of Randall Grichuk saunters into the batter's box next. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball.
Hey, he's had great command all day. Want to see how aggressive he is in the zone with a three-ball count.
Hits are now even at four apiece. And a fastball swung on and missed, and the side is retired. At the plate now is Andrew Velasquez. Comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out. And stepping in, Jonathan Davis. It was a walk in his last trip. Now the 1-1 pitch. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Long run for the center fielder. He gets there, and that's the second out. So the bases are empty here with two gone, and that'll bring in DJ LeMahieu. 3-1 is our score here in inning number four. Hit on the ground to third. Reined in. Throw cleanly into first, and that ends the inning. ready to go in the top of the fifth. And standing in, the outfielder, Lourdes Gurriel.
Yeah, Matt, going back to that last AB, that was a pretty good fastball down in the zone, so that tells me this guy likes to get that bat head down, and he covers that low pitch quite well. It's difficult at times, though, because as a pitcher, you're taught to stay down in the zone. If you do that, you're throwing it right into this guy's wheelhouse.
And this is taken in just shy of the warning track for out number one. Next up is Santiago Espinal. Flied out in his first at-bat, so make him 0 for 1 so far. The 2-1. Here's a bouncing ball headed to LeMahieu at second. And there are two away now. Stepping in once again is Reese McGuire.
He turned around that fastball and drove it out of the park in his previous at-bat, so there's got to be a good chance they mix it up right here on him and try and go off speed.
Pops this one up. Stanton coming on. He can't get there as it falls in. The throw into second. The tag, and they'll get him at second. And with that, the side is retired. Standing in now, Aaron Judge. And it's fouled away.
This guy's been throwing the ball great so far, but it's going to be tested here. 4, 5, and 6 coming up this part of the lineup.
Fouled off. Hard ground ball to third. He's got it. And the throw is wide as it pulls the first baseman off the bag.
Up next to the game.
So it's a runner at no first as a result of the throwing error. And standing in is the veteran outfielder, Giancarlo Stanton. Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone. Just got a piece of it as it's fouled back. Got him! And he goes down on strikes for the third time. Next to dig in, Luke Voit. Single last time up. He's set. Here comes the 1-1.
Wow, I'm shocked the hitter took it right there. That's a well-executed pitch down in the zone to try and get that double play.
Here's a shot to left field and deep. Look at this. And that one is gone.
You don't see this very often off of this starting pitcher. This guy's not used to giving up some bombs, so I'm sure that'll be a wake-up call, and he'll start throwing some better pitches.
Into the box now, Joey Gallo. Here's a foul ball left side, and that'll move it to 1-2. Back up the middle and in for a base hit.
Now back, the catcher, Gary.
Stepping in now, Gary Sanchez. 2-1. Two and two the count. And he fouls this one off. Swung on and hit pretty well out to deep left field. And, oh, he missed a home run by a matter of feet. It's off the wall. The relay, and he'll make it into second as he just misses the home run, but he'll settle for two bases.
The first baseman, Anthony.
And now, Anthony Rizzo. Two balls and a strike to the Yankees' first baseman.
It's not easy to continue pounding the strike zone when you've given up three consecutive hits, but he has to trust that getting the ball down in the zone will get him an out.
The count now at 2-2. Two balls and two strikes to Rizzo.
For the guy in the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
Full count here. Here comes the pitch.
Yeah, you could tell he was ready for another fastball, but the pitcher went to breaking ball, and the hitter just fouls that one off.
Hard hit ball to second. Simeon's got it. Throw to first is in time, but meanwhile, the runner is in to score. Next to hit, Andrew Velasquez. Runner in scoring position with two gone. Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. And he struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. So here is Marcus Semien. He'll get us going for the Jays in their half of the sixth. Right side, but it's going to be a foul ball. The 2-2.
What we're seeing here is a really smart at bat. They got to be thinking the man on the mound is getting a little short on gas, so when you go up there and make him throw a bunch of pitches, you're more likely to get a good pitch to hit or at least force him out of the game.
So the breaking ball locked him up there. Marcus Semien becomes the first out of the inning. Up next, Bo Bichette. He's singled in two trips to the plate thus far. Sent on the ground out to second. LeMahieu's got it, and there's out number two. Next, it'll be Vladimir Guerrero Jr. Third trip to the plate for him here tonight. 0 for 2 at this point. A 2-1 count to the Blue Jays first baseman. And he can't catch the corner here, so he's behind 3-1.
Call didn't go his way on 2-1, but it's important here on 3-1 to still make a quality pitch. You have to have the mindset that you're still the one in the driver's seat.
The 3-2 pitch. There's ball four. So that'll bring in Teoscar Hernandez. No hits to this point.
Right fielder, Teoscar Hernandez.
Now the 2-1 pitch. Hernandez connects and sends it to deep left. And they take the lead. It's gone. So now to the plate, Corey Dickerson. That nibbled the corner there, but missed 2-1. Hit to first. Rizzo was there. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Trevor Richards enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth.
Pitching for Toronto, number 33.
Leading off the inning, it'll be Jonathan Davis as they'll look to spark the offense and even things up. High and deep down the left field line. Nearly a big fly to start the inning. Instead, a foul ball. Now another 1-2.
Inside, ball two.
Still even at 2-2. Locked in a good battle. Here comes another one. Weak grounder back to the mound. And a good throw gets him one gone. Here's the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu.
The second baseman, DJ.
Bases are empty, one man out.
LeMahieu.
And the count will be full. Hit in the air down the right field line. But this is going to wind up a foul ball. The next 3-2. Little tardy on that swing as it's well wide of first. Neither guy giving in here, and they'll do it again. Again, another foul ball. Four runs, seven hits, and no errors for the Yankees so far. Lets him off the hook there, as this isn't even close for ball four.
The right fielder, number 99.
And that'll bring up Aaron Judge. He reached on an error and later scored his last time up. Now the 2-1 pitch. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Gurriel is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. And digging into the batter's box next will be Giancarlo Stanton. He went down on strikes last time up.
Giancarlo Stanton.
At the letters, but called high, it's a ball. Luke Voit would be next. Now a fastball swung on and missed, and it's full 3-2.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Hit on the ground to short. Bichette gathers it in over to first, and that retires the side. Jonathan Loaisiga is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven.
Number 43, Jonathan.
Randall Grichuk at the plate now. 0 for 2 from him so far in this one. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. He struck him out, the third time he's fanned in the game. So now to the plate, Lourdes Gurriel. He flew out in his last AB. The 2-1 home. Ripped on the ground to first. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. Now to the plate, here is Santiago Espinal. 0 for 2 with a fly ball and a ground out on his line to this point. The 3-1 pitch. Fastball too high, ball four. Next to bat for Toronto, Reese McGuire. He's got hits in both of his at-bats so far in this one. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Stanton has a read on it, and the inning is over.
Ladies and gentlemen, please join us for the traditional seventh inning stretch.
Trent Thornton will take over on the mound to start the bottom of the seventh.
Number 57.
Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and next the dangerous power threat, Luke Voit. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. This is line to left. Another base hit. How about the game he's putting together? Now 4 for 4 in this one. With that, the Yankees have put their leadoff hitter aboard to start out the inning.
The third baseman, number 13, Joey.
To the plate now, Joey Gallo. Called strike two on the cutter, and he's behind in the count now, 1-2.
Might have been taking all the way right there. That pitch couldn't have split the strike zone any better. And you can bet he wants that one back at the plate.
Now so he sets him down swinging. Joey Gallo is retired for the first out in the bottom half of the seventh inning. Fouled away. A swing and a miss as they got him with the slider there, two away. Number 58 is ready, and he'll take the ball from the manager.
Anthony
Rizzo will be the first to greet him here as he stands in with a runner at first and two away. Up high, 2-1 now. And they set up away with the fastball, but it misses, 3-1.
Well, this is the matchup they wanted, bringing in the reliever, but falling behind 2-0 doesn't exactly help the situation very much.
And he missed with it, ball four. So that means now the potential tying run will move into scoring position at second. Hit in the air out to straightaway left. Left fielder giving chase. He's there to make the play, and that'll retire the side. Ready to begin the eighth, and that'll give way to the veteran second baseman, Marcus Semien. The 1-2 misses above the zone for a ball.
We all know he's a really good hitter, and this is probably a good example why. He fell behind 0-2, but knowing they're probably going to try to get him to chase a pitcher's pitch, he got really patient. He's still up against the ropes a little, but he's in a much better position now on a 2-2 count.
Got him swinging on the fastball there. Marcus Semien goes down to become the first out in the eighth inning. Ground ball right side. LeMahieu gets to it from deep in the hole. A flip from short right gets him, and there are two away. Stepping in for the Jays, Vladimir Guerrero Jr., 0-for-2 on his line thus far. Base hit, line drive into the corner. At the plate, Teoscar Hernandez. Change up just off the black, and it's 2-1. And it's 2 balls and 2 strikes now.
Love the fact the pitcher challenged him in that spot right there. Didn't love the location. But I got to be honest with you, I think he's got him on his heels right now. Don't be sure.
Now here's a fly ball. Well hit. Racing back, the right fielder. And that one is gone. On a 2-strike count with 2 away in the inning. Into the box now, Corey Dickerson. And a pitch down that swung on and sent to second base. They'll whip this one to first in time, and that ends the inning. Adam Simber is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 90, Adam.
Leading off the inning, it'll be Jonathan Davis, and they could use a spark from him here. The 1-1.
That's a ball.
He'll try to bunt his way on as he gets this one down. But this will be a foul ball as that evens things at 2-2. Now the pitch. Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first out. Up and that sends DJ LeMahieu into the box.
Baseman, DJ LeMahieu.
The 2-1 is looked at for ball three.
Got to find a way to scratch at least one across. You do not want to take on the monster closing the game down three.
Inside, he misses ball four. So a runner at first now with one away, and that'll bring up the big bat of Aaron Judge.
Judge.
Ready with the 1-1 pitch.
Right guy, right spot. This is one of the better hitters in their lineup. Just the guy they want to see coming up now to get this inning going.
Here's the 2-1 home. Good bite to that sinker as he gets him to swing through it for out number two. Now at the plate, here is Giancarlo Stanton. He grounded out last time up.
Stanton.
The 1-1. High and deep down the left field line. And he just couldn't keep that ball fair as it winds up a long foul ball. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at bat here. He'll try again, 1-2. LeMahieu leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. And he'll strike out here yet again, as it's been a ballgame to forget thus far. 4 strikeouts. Clay Holmes enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. Here's Randall Grichuk. He was sat down on strikes in his last at bat. On the ground to the right side, Rizzo is there. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway.
Up next to the blue.
So now here is Lourdes Gurriel. Perhaps he can drive another one out of the park just like he did back in the second. Hot shot on the ground is short. Throw gets him, two down. So the next to bat will be Santiago Espinal. It was a walk in his last trip. Won't go after the 2-1 sinker, and it's three balls and a strike now. And this one misses inside, a ball he walked in, and they've got themselves a two-out base runner. Next up, Reese McGuire. He homered back in the third inning in this one. And the pitch on 2-1. Down the first baseline. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Jordan Romano enters the game to finish this one off here in the bottom of the ninth.
Number 68, Jordan.
All set for the bottom of the ninth. And striding forward, the designated hitter, Luke Voit.
Hey, not impossible, but highly improbable, even when you're at home, to score three runs off a closer like this guy.
Oh, hang on now. This ball is crushed into left field, and this one ain't coming back. This ball is gone.
That, my friends, is a cardinal sin for any closer. You can't give up the long ball. Good thing for him, he still has the lead. We'll see now if he can rebound and actually keep it.
Standing in now, Joey Gallo. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. This ball will be chopped foul. He's set. Here's the 2-2. Pulled toward right center field. There to play it is Grichuk, and that's the first out. Now with the plate is Gary Sanchez.
The catcher, Gary Sanchez.
Crowd gets up for the 3-2. Pulls this one in the air out to left. Left fielder is on the move. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out. Anthony Rizzo stands in now. He comes to the plate as the last chance for his side. Two out here in the ninth. Now the pitch.
Hey, this isn't going to be an easy save. These guys are making them work for this one.
And this is swung on and missed. So now they find themselves down to their final strike tonight.
Now this guy's got some of the nastiest stuff in the game, and it is absolutely no fun for an offense to try and piece together.
Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over.
Well, that's not exactly how you draw it up. He gave up a long ball to make it interesting, but it was the only run he gave up, and he hangs on to collect a save.
7-5 tonight's final. Toronto blasted five home runs en route to victory. Jose Berríos is the winning pitcher of record. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com.
Fans, our final line score tonight. First for the victorious Blue Jays, 7 runs, 8 hits, 1 error. They left 3 men on base.